Yesterday we started the learning Sanskrita. It's we are implementing greetings. Namo namoha. It's equivalent to in English hi. It's welcome all. It's good morning, good afternoon, good evening from wherever you are joining. This last week is the beginning of a new year in Indian calendar. Every year has a name. There are 60 names and one cycle is 60. 60 names and human life is regarded as two cycles. One cycle is called a Shashti Purti. Two Shashti Purti is the full expansion. Full expansion of that it's a lifespan. And every year has a name, and this year's name is called as Plava. The name that year, according to the Indian system, there are according to the lunar calendar, if you start from Chaitra first day, Pratipat, to Chaitra to its last day, it is Palguni. Palguni in the last, its last day, so 355 days are there. 355 days in the according to the lunar calendar. It is called as Anu Vatsara. Anu is a short form. And Anu also means one follows. And according to the solar calendar, there are 365.25 days according to the solar calendar. From the Mesha, first day of Mesha, Mesha to Meena. Meena, last day, 365.25. It is called as Samvatsara, complete year. According to the solar calendar, it's a complete year. Lunar calendar, 355 days. To Anu Vatsara, it follows the Samvatsara. There is a gap of 10 days. 10 days, there is a lag in the lunar calendar. That is why after 3 years, they add one more month. It's 10, 10, 10, 30 days. It's called as Adhikamas. They add one extra month to compensate, to match up with the solar calendar. One is lunar calendar is called as lunar year. It is called as Anuvatsara. Solar is called as Samvatsara. And average of lunar and solar, it is 360 days. It is called as Vatsara. 355 plus 366 and divided by 2 is 360 days, is called as Vatsara. 360, it's a Vatsara, has a significance in our life also. It's a special number, 360. In the Brihati Chandas, it has a letter of 36 letters. And in this 360 days, it has 360 days, it has a 360 daytime and 360 night time. 360 plus 360 is 720. 720, it's days in a human lifespan of 100 years, that is 72,000 days. What is our lifespan? 72,000 days. When you look at that one, very short. We are doing so many things, useless things. It's 72,000 days. In this body, there are 72,000 nadis. And it's 36 on the Ida side, 36 on the Pingala side. It is a mathematics. In this Ayurveda, in the system, it talks about in the body, if you count how many marrows and bones are there, 360 bones. They put that one as 360, they counted. Bones and marrows put together is 360. And when they are doing the havan, how many bricks they had to use? 360 bricks they had to use. All signifies with your body. It is aligning. It is mathematics is involved because it is aligning with what is the system in the body. And this year's name is called as Plava. Plava means boat. Boat, and we are jumping on many boats thinking that it will sail me across to the shore. And after traveling few days, we realize my boat has holes. And I jumped on a wrong boat. And this is a sinking boat. I thought this boat will sail me across, take me to the other side. In fact, it is sinking me, many of us. And it is by the time we realize it is too late. It is too late. I'm in the middle of the ocean. I can't jump off, nor I can't swim. And we get drowned in the life. Plava, you need to look at the right boat in the life before you jump on. Your lifespan is only 72,000 days. You need to select the right boat, trustworthy boat, which will sail you across. Yoga is called as a boat. Yoga is a boat. It's a solid boat, strong boat. It will help you to sail you across, take you to the other side of your the ocean. And in this, when we are sailing, we are hit with six waves. Heavy waves are in the ocean. It is tossing the boat up and down. It is called a shadurmis. Shadurmi, six boats. Six boats are the six waves, which are heavy, like a tsunami type of waves, which is trying to toss this boat. What are the six ways, waves? It is talking about in the scriptures, in the Upanishad also it talks about. It is called kshut pipasa, hunger and thirst. This 72,000 days, I am in search of only the hunger and thirst. Some people only spend their time only for quenching their hunger and thirst. And that kshut pipasa and shoka and moha, depression. I have a depression. I don't want to get up in my life. Or it's a shoka and moha, too attached to the trivial things in my life. This is, I have forgotten, my lifespan is only 72,000 days. I'm so possessive, moha, so attached to the things, and when I lost that one, it gone into depression. When I did not get that one, when I go into, it's a depression. And that another two waves, it is talking about jara and mrityu, old age. Old age, 72,000. Unknowingly, old age slowly sets in without your knowledge. It is coming here. Old age has set in and another boat. It is trying to topple you down. Old age and mrityu. And before that one, six waves are there. Before that, we have to try to sail across. Hunger, I'm never satisfied in my life. I want more. Greed, so much. I'm not satisfied with what I have. And I forget, I have only 72,000 days to sail across. And so much of insatiable hunger. I want more in my life. Never satisfied. It's kshut pipasa. Shoka and moha, depression and attachment, and before then, old age, it's too late, I can't get up, and it's old age, and then ultimately that another way called as mrityu, they are trying to topple our boat, and for that, we need a boat. The boat, it's yoga is a boat, but we need a trustworthy boatman. We need a trustworthy boatman. Whom can I trust? Whom can I trust? That boatman who will sail, make sure that he will, all the tides are coming, he will maneuver around such a way that he will take me across. Who is that boatman? And I need that boatman. In when your yoga is a boat, yoga, when you are in a boat, you need to repose your trust in a boatman. Who is that boatman? It's a Supreme Lord. In Purandaradasa, he composed a song also, Ambiga na ninna nambide. I fully trust the boatman. In the past, I trusted so many boat people. They themselves are sinking. What can they protect? I trusted so many people. They themselves are sinking. Now, I am trusting only the Supreme Lord. He is the only one boatman who will make sure that he will take me across. He will take me across. And this yoga, for me also, this is a boat. I am yoga as a boat I am using. And in this journey, many people are tagging along with me, that the tide of this boat, many people are trying to get a momentum. In this boat, they are trying to tagging on or jumping on to this boat. Few of them are jumping on. They are wanting to sail across. And yoga is the boat, and never, it's a lifelong commitment. When you start, do not stop. When you start, and because your lifespan, it's a 72,000 days. And in the plava is the message for this year, you need a strong boat. You, in the past, you tried to jump onto many boats. Now, do not jump off. Have a full trust in the Supreme Lord and sail and try to sail across, and so that you will overcome all the tides in your life and all the tsunamis won't topple the boat, and you should reach the other end of the shore. And when you enroll this, the first class for this term, and yoga should be your lifelong companion. Do not jump off. Trust in the boatman and sail across. Lie down on your back.